What's not all over the place is this man's talent, Cory Cruise. Welcome to the newsroom, sir.
Honored to be here. Thank you for having me.
I was looking forward to chatting with you. As I tell a lot of my interview guests, especially the musical ones, I like to listen to your music before I read your bio. I just want to hear the voice. I want to hear what I'm about to interview. You've got such a rich tonality to your voice.
I appreciate that.
And this is last 2 years have been pretty good for you in terms of playing a lot of these award shows.
Been very busy. Actually, I did 100 shows this summer, which was absolutely insane.
Wow.
Yeah.
100. Our summer is only about 100 days.
My plan was to do 92 shows in 92 days. I ended up doing 95 and actually added another 5. So yeah, it was. I had 3 and 4. The most I had this year was 5 shows in one day.
And that's
crazy.
You know, when you play shows, that's how you develop your chops. Mm-hmm. And you know, I watched a lot of your videos and I could see you're very comfortable with the acoustic guitar. I even said I think it should be surgically attached to you because it just seems like it's an extension of you. Describe your music for people who don't really know who you are.
Well, I guess someone from Toronto that might know Dallas Green. You guys know who Dallas Green is, our sitting caller. His father put it best, I think. He said, "Cory, you're acoustically delicious," and I've coined it. So, Mike, I stole it off you. But acoustically delicious is, I guess, the best quote I've heard so far.
You know, even when I first time, you know, I hear an acoustic guitar, you have a very softer tonality to your voice, but you could really project, and I almost, you know, I heard a little, when I hear things like More Than Words from Extreme, that just that softness, and that really comes out of your music. In terms of where you're hoping to go with the music, what's the plan?
It's day by day, and you know, responses like that are absolutely amazing to me. I'm very shy and nervous with it, and I've never actually done any super professional recording yet. And a lot of my friends are pushing me. They're like, "You really got to record." So I'm looking at that, and I'd like to actually find some people maybe in Toronto that would like to record me or like to dabble in that. So
you're a great songwriter, and I understand you contributed something for the Canadian Forces.
Absolutely.
Tell me about that.
Yeah, my little brother's in Special Forces now. He's out in Edmonton. And I wrote a song for the fallen soldiers, Tyler Crooks and Master Corporal Scott Vernelli were killed. And I dedicated a song to their families. And I know they're watching right now, so hi, guys. But I wrote a song for those guys and dedicated it for all of them. And I do a lot of support with the NWRA and things like that.
Fantastic. I know writing is important to you, but also performing. And you're going to be performing at the Gourmet Food and Wine Expo.
Absolutely.
Tell us about the details.
I am super excited about it. Tickets are still available if anybody wants to get them today. Enrique is playing actually after me from 3 to 6. I'm on at 12 to 3. And I think it's going to be an amazing time. I think tickets are $20, so I mean, you can't beat it. Food, wine, I mean, music. I mean, how much more can you ask for?
You know, when you perform, generally with your acoustic guitar, and there's something I always find unique about someone who just goes up on stage just with their piano, just with their acoustic guitar. There's nowhere to hide.
Absolutely.
And that's what makes I think that kind of performance so organic and so authentically real. Mm-hmm. In terms of the choice to just be a solo and only your guitar, was that a conscious decision, or were you hoping to bring in more members?
I would love to work with other people. I'm just, like I said, I'm so nervous. I'm still growing with it, and the recordings and stuff that I do have, like home recordings, it's me playing drums and bass guitar and everything that way. So once I break out of the shell, I think a bit more and come out into the, I guess, the public eye, as you'd say, let's see what happens.
And in terms of trying to move the career forward, because it's a tough biz.
Absolutely.
You know, I used to work in the music industry. It's a tough one. What are some of the other ways you're doing to try and get your music out there? Because at the end of the day, a lot of artists, they have to manage their own business. They have to book their own shows and tours and stuff like that. So what are you trying to do to get
absolutely
that out there?
I haven't really set a bar. I've played everything from farmers markets to the Luminacqua in Welland, which holds like 1,500 people, and it's a whole other thing. But I'm just as nervous at both shows, and I still perform, I guess, the same way. So it's just a matter of just keep doing what I'm doing, and I mean, if someone likes it, that's amazing. You just got to get through to one person. If they feel that, that's amazing to me.
You know, at the end of the day, you know, musicians get into this because they just love music.
Yeah.
They just love to play.
Yeah, you have to.
The business is always kind of going to be there, but I'm guessing it's just really important for you as an artist to just get out there, perform in front of people, and get your music to the masses. Cory, thank you so much
for
joining us.
And
once again, you're playing at the Metro Toronto Convention Center. This is for the Gourmet Food and Wine Expo. And once again, what time are you playing?
I'm on at 12 o'clock.
12 o'clock.
12 to 3.
Just a couple of hours away. Thank you so much for stopping by.
Hope
you can come back again. You've been watching CP24 Breakfast Week, and we're going to leave you with a little bit more Cory Cruise. You're here, I'm lost in the valley. we've got Cory Cruise right now performing Yellow Room. Have a great day, everybody.
She looks at me from across the room. There's nothing more I think I could have said until my breathing resumes. So I stayed quiet. And whoa, she's been a dream every night since I saw her last in the yellow room. There's something more I'll try to say this time before I get consumed in this silence. I might let her know she's behind this. So when you're always what I wanted, will you tell me that I'm too late? I'm standing here tonight, so in love I've fallen. Please tell me you feel the same. Please tell me you feel the same. And I said, whoa, oh, I want you, how I need you to. Whoa, oh, I want you, just to want me to. Well, everything that I had known blows up here into my face. Goes through a grind from underneath my feet. She's walking this way, now she's smiling. She walks right up to me and says, will you always what I've wanted? Will you tell me that I'm too late? I'm standing here tonight, so in love I've fallen.